Let's take a look at the action in the gold area on the heels of Newmont Mining's $10 billion acquisition of Goldcorp. The Gold Miners ETF, the ticker GDX, that has both companies in it, amongst the top 10 holdings, as you might expect, given the size of the deal, down for the start of the year and down about 15% over the last 12 months. Brian Sullivan joins us now. He's got more color from the CEO of Newmont Mining on that big deal announced a couple of days ago. Brian.
Yeah, David, thank you very much. In fact, a few minutes ago, we spoke first on CNBC with Newmont Mining CEO Gary Goldberg. Now, he's going to become the CEO of the newly minted company called Newmont Goldcorp, at least through the end of the year, and then he'll leave and give the job to Tom Palmer. Now, this is the second huge deal, David, as you know, in a couple of months in gold. Last year, Barrick Gold bought Randgold for $6.5 billion. So we asked Goldberg if this deal was a signal flare that he thinks gold prices are going to stay lower for longer.
We're designing our business to survive through the cycles in prices. We're not predicting an up or down. As we go through our longer-term plans, we use a $1,200 gold price, and we're really focused on returns and making sure that any project, any business going forward is delivering at least a 15% rate of return.
I don't need to tell a lot of our viewers and listeners that gold has been a dead money trade for a long time now. Remember, we were above $1,700 an ounce back in October of 2011. For the next 4 years, it went down, down, down. Now it's kind of been stuck, guys, in that range around $1,200 for a few years. But remember, it fell nearly below $1,000 in late 2016. So I asked Goldberg how confident he is in that $1,200 projection.
We do test our plans at an $800 price, $900, and then up to $1,200. So, you know, at this stage, you look at past history and look at where we're at, I think we sit in a solid position in terms of cost of production to be able to compete through the cycles.
And I think Goldberg, guys, wants to make sure the market understands the deal. It doesn't appear that they do. The stock is down about 8% this week. The deal was announced Monday morning, so clearly, there are skeptics that this kind of a deal is going to pay off. Goldberg also talked about how they can cut costs, especially in the two offices. Now, there's no overlap in their physical mines, but maybe they can achieve more economies of scale. The full interview will be on CNBC.com, guys, but still not a lot of optimism around the price of gold at $1,200, and that's where we are now. So there you go.